hey people, thank you very much for checking out this channel and for making it for what it's worth. Let's get this promise started. I am Alan's Lamb, a scholar of the ancient Evilese history. Have you ever heard of the Lion War? It divided Evilese in over two who would be the successor to the throne. It ended with the appearance of a young hero named Dalida. I know I'm flubbing. Well, everybody knows here the hero's tale. But we also know that what we see with our eyes alone isn't necessarily the truth. Here's a young man. He is the youngest son of the noble family below, the pillars of knighthood, and really likes the ass shot. There's no record of his playing an active part in history, but according to the Duray report released last year, concealed for many years by the church, this unknown man is the true hero. The church claims he was a blasphemer, an anarchist, the rule of all evil. But is this the truth? Won't you join me on a journey for this truth? Before that, please tell me your name and birthday. Okay, let's get into the brass tacks of this playthrough. I'm not using story characters unless it's necessary or for thematic reasons. Otherwise, aside from Ramza, who I'm renaming as Razid. The heck? Well, I'm only using customized characters. The customized characters will be special in its own way, but you'll see what I mean soon enough in about a half hour. You'll see what I mean soon enough. And that's my actual birthday. Square Enix presents a game from my childhood. I would be playing it with my physical copy, but it's not working so good, so I'm resorting to an emulated version. I do have a real copy of the game. Manual and all. Fire. Fantasy. Soak it in, people! We're in it for a medieval mayhem. There's a reason for the generic looking appearance and no clear discernible features. And that's this game's custom character feature. The characters are generic based on their job class, but you could name them whoever you want and they'll have the same star sign you choose. It's tedious on the how you choose the star sign, but it's worth it. This cutscene kind of reminds me of the first exposure to the game I had. It was a rental in Hollywood Video. At the time, since it was only 5 days, I didn't have enough time to actually get past the first major battle. I'll get with it being soon enough. But that will be a couple parts later. Too fast to identify job class. And don't worry, I'm not gonna read everything. I'm just gonna read certain points and this opening sequence. The Orbon Monastery. But I'm just gonna be talking otherwise. I really want this an experience for us to all interact together. Miyamoto, please help us sinful children of Ivalice. Point being, I really want to just this let's play. Besides being a promise, I want an excuse to really interact with you guys. You know, really have a good conversation. You know? It'll just be fun just to really chat with y'all. Maybe it'll influence some new remixes I'm doing down the road. Maybe not, but maybe you have some advice you want. Whatever the reason, let these videos be at least an excuse to really chat. What's going on here? It's been nearly an hour! Don't be rude to the Princess Gifgarian! Is this going to be all right, Agrius? This is an urgent issue for us. So there are rude names, even amongst the Hokuten. I'm being more than kind to the guard captains here. Besides, we're mercenaries hired by the Hokuten. I'm not obliged to show respect to you. What? How dare you? Enough, let's go.
Go with God.
You do.
Gultana's men?
Whee!
What one must do to make money? What, Rizzy? You have a problem too?
I'm no longer a knight, just a mercenary like you.
That's right. Well then, let's go.
Yep, my sentiment's exact. Now, for people not familiar with the genre, it's of the same vein as Fire Emblem. Think of it as a game of battle chess, to best put it. Each piece has their own moves, abilities, and whatever, and they have their own levels and stats to work with. But unlike Fire Emblem that uses a smaller scale for damage, this one goes up higher up, plus it has two distinct advantages over Fire Emblem. Let's get into that, shall we? First, it's more objective-based. But usually it's beat all enemies, or a specific enemy. Funny enough, here's the one distinct difference. One, you have occasional allies that will be guests. They'll move and act on their own. They have their own set priorities on how they do things. Two, in this game, you can have actual camera control. So you can see stuff from different angles, you can zoom in, zoom out, and you, sometimes we'll be able to
there's a lot more tactical elements. Another thing you'll notice that there's a star sign in representing Aquarius next to the Brave New Faith. This affects how I perform in battle, depending on who's with me and who's against me. I can move freely and act, and I don't necessarily have to do it in the same order. Each character has a class that can be changed. At the moment, for this battle, I have these classes available. He's the most basic and standard. He has nothing special for now. Chemist lets you use items. Knights are of the traditional Final Fantasy type, and you get to use the break moves. More on that later. And archers are just archers. I would say more, but really there's not much to them except arch attacks. Now, the Brave system works like this. It affects your ability for magic. Actually, Brave affects your physical stats, like your counter rate and how potent you are with physical attacks. Faith, on the other hand, handles the magic side of things in response to magical things, as well as your magic attack and defense. As you can see, broken. Archers can need just do raw damage and range. The higher ground they are, the more range they have. So it's all in realism. Another key feature is that they can focus their attack for a more potent blow. It's usually stronger, but there's nothing really special about them. Dark Knight's exclusive to this guy, and essentially this guy alone. He has a couple of techniques, but they mostly drain. With Dark Sword restoring health to him, equal to the amount of damage he dealt, and Night Sword draining MP. However, in the remake, the class will become accessible to everyone. Looks like I'm running short on time. Well, we'll finish the battle next time. I'll be sure to upload this next part in tandem. Peace!